New Zealand for you this morning alongside Alistair Eakin, Helen Fospero and Phil Williams here with you at Five Live headquarters. And let's talk about tonight's Strictly Come Dancing then. Back on BBC One, just one show this weekend. It's a live show and the pressure is on because unlike The X Factor and their twist this week on Strictly, someone will be voted off. Yesterday I caught up with the Australian actress and singer Holly Valance and her partner Artem Chigvintsev.
Someone is going for the first time, so we're gearing up for disappointment either. Hopefully not our own, but it's going to be sad seeing one of our mates go for sure.
You were quite good though, weren't you, last weekend? I was quite impressed.
I think we're all right for the first dance.
Possible.
Well, the thing is, I'm never too happy with my performance anyway, but I think Holly did like a great job for the first dance, especially going first. It was nerve-wracking, I'm sure.
It was petrifying. I thought it was awful. Watching playback now, I'm like, oh God, it made me work extra hard at training this week, so I just thought, I don't want to look like that again.
Why? Which bit were you not happy with?
The bit where I looked like newborn foal that couldn't walk. That bit. So it was just amateurish, and I guess I'm allowed for the first few weeks a little bit, but I got to spark it up this week.
Are you as hard on yourself as Artem is on himself?
I am really hard on myself. He's really hard on me, so it's perfect.
Is that because you did so well last year?
Last year was successful for me. It adds pressure to the next year because you kind of want to keep the standard going or trying to do better than that. And, I mean, it is quite tough, but I'm up for the challenge and, you know, do my best.
Some of the papers reporting that you weren't happy last week, that you had to dance on Friday instead of Saturday. Is that true? Any truth in that, or is that just paper talk?
It was hysterical because we were high-fiving. We were so rapt to go first, get it over and done with, sit back, enjoy the rest of the show. I'm the kind of person, if you give me too much time, I would sit there having proper anxiety.
Oh, really?
So it was good when they switched me around. I was like, oh, that's better. I can enjoy my weekend.
Big relief.
Yeah. No one wants to go last, trust me. It's just builds and builds and builds. It's torture, so we were quite happy to go first.
And I noticed on the Saturday show, and obviously you were out of the way then, but I think there was some talk about some of the dancers being a bit demoralised, especially by Craig's comments on the Friday. Was there a bit of gloom in the camp?
A little bit, but I guess that's all part of the entertainment of it. I have to sort of think about that's his character and that he's there to be the tough nut, I guess. So I'm going to expect it and not take it personally and just try and take it as constructive criticism, work it into the next week's training. That's all I can do, really. I don't want to go home and have a little cry.
What about you, Artem?
I think he was quite tough on some people. We always have to remember.
I think I liked it because he wasn't tough on us.
We always have to remember it's the first week for them and it's the first time they're stepping on the dance floor and performing. So I'd rather encourage them to get better for the next week.
Did you watch Holly in Neighbours, or have you seen all the stuff that she's done? Have you seen Taken? Have you seen her body of work?
Oh, I've seen Taken. Yes, I did. It was a great film. It's actually one of my favorite films. I've seen bits of her music career and the song specifically Kiss Kiss. If we go long, far in the competition, we got to do a samba, maybe we'll be able to use that song. That'd be terrific.
Are you cool with that?
Oh, not really. I don't know about that. We might have to have a little discussion off
air. It's a massive smash hit. What's not to like?
No, it's not that I don't like it. I don't know. It feels strange. It's
dancing
like
to
it's
your
an
song.
Amalgamation of two totally different jobs. Yeah, it'd be weird.
I think it'd be fine as long as you're lip syncing through the whole dance. Would be okay.
Talking of Neighbours, Jason's quite good as well, isn't he?
Yeah.
I can't remember now. I was trying to cast my mind back. Was there much crossover between your times in Neighbours?
I like to remind Jace that it was about 15 years between us. I like to drop that in at least three or four times a day. Yeah. No, he is divine. I absolutely adore him, and he's doing a wonderful job. And it would be super cool if the Aussies went far.
And if it was what you and him in the final?
That would be pretty fun. Yeah, that'd be great.
Very long way, I know. So let's not get ahead of us.
I can't even fathom like next week, let alone that, but it's a nice little dream.
Holly and Artem speaking yesterday afternoon. I have to say, Helen, because I know you watch it, they look to get on really well. I mean, that wasn't kidded along for the microphone, you know.
No,
I think
they're going to do really well. I mean, of course, you remember the last series, Artem actually won.
Didn't he?
And Holly, I think, has enough talent to get right through to the final. It's going to be very interesting.
Strictly Come Dancing, BBC One tonight at 6:05.
We'll be there on the Fospero couch watching it. Anyway, Sebastian Vettel, a